Hello, I am pleased to welcome this ninth launch of the year, the third with a Soyuz launcher. For this mission, Soyuz launcher will deliver five satellites to a Sun synchronous orbit at different altitudes. One of these is CHEOPS, the Characterising Exoplanet Satellite, an European Space Agency scientific mission dedicated to the study of planets outside our solar system. CHEOPS will lift off as a secondary passenger and it will be delivered at an altitude of 700 km in a down-dusk Sun synchronous orbit to observe bright stars already known to host exoplanets. This orbit has been selected to ensure stable thermal conditions and minimize the effects of the Earth's straight light on the scientific measurements. Through high-precision monitoring of a star's brightness, scientists will examine the transit of a planet as it passes briefly across the star's face. The acquired parameters will provide an indication of the internal structure of the planet and will help scientists to understand the formation of planets from a few times the mass of the Earth up to the Neptune-sized worlds. The data also will help refine ideas about how planets change orbits during the formation and evolution of their parent systems. Now, we can move on to the three auxiliary passengers of these missions, Angels, EyeSat and OPSAT. Angels, Argos Neo on a generic economical and light satellite, is the first made-in-France nanosatellite. Angels is a 12U CubeSat. It is jointly financed and developed by the French CNES Space Agency and Emiria, affiliate of Nexeia. The satellite is fitted, among the others, with a miniaturized Argos Neo instrument, which is 10 times smaller than the equivalent previous generation device. Being the payload developed by Thales Alenia Space and Sirlings, Angels will join the current constellation of Argos instruments. Built in only 30 months using what is commonly called the new space approach, it paves the way to new low-cost operational missions in various fields such as IoT. EyeSat is a student CubeSat which belongs to Janus, Jeune en apprentissage pour la réalisation des nanosatellites des universités et des écoles de l'enseignement supérieur, a CNES program that supports French universities in developing their CubeSat projects. The specificity of EyeSat is that it has been developed within the French Space Agency since 2012, with more than 250 students involved. EyeSat, a 3U CubeSat, is equipped with a small homemade telescope IRIS and will observe the zodiacal light, sunlight scattered by interplanetary dust. For 1 year, EyeSat will produce more than 500 GB of data, which will be downloaded to the ground thanks to the high data rate X-band link. OPSAT will be the first satellite launched by Arianespace for Tyvak on behalf of ESA. Tyvak offers access to space by providing end-to-end, cost-effective space systems using agile aerospace processes and accelerating on-orbit access. Tyvak International of Italy provided the deployer and launch service for OPSAT on behalf of ESA. OPSAT is the world's first free-for-use in-orbit testbed for new software, applications and techniques in satellite control, bringing Europe forward to a new era of space flight innovation and commercial opportunity. In the first year of operation, OPSAT will host over 100 in-flight experiments submitted from many ESA member states. OPSAT was developed by the Graz University of Technology with subcontractors from Austria, Germany, Poland and Denmark. It is operated by ESA from the European Space Operations Center in Germany. I would like to thank all the teams involved in this mission for their professionalism and spirit of cooperation. Thank you.